At one time, I remember I heard like two shots, but it sounded like a little pellet gun or something.
Okay. Was that when you were in the closet?
I think I was still in the room then.
Okay.
But I wasn't sure. I thought maybe it was just some kid with a BB gun.
Okay. That was while he was gone and went back to your bedroom and you were in there by yourself and you heard two shots of some kind?
Yeah.
Okay.
The phone was ringing a lot and he didn't answer it. And then someone was pounding on the door. And then some guy was screaming. He said, "David, come out here. It's Lonnie." And he kept saying, "Come out here." And then that's when David climbed up there with me and he covered it up. He told me, he said, "I have a knife right here."
Did you see the knife? Did you feel it? Did he stick it to your side or your arm or anything?
No, because I was laying flat down and I couldn't see anything.
Pretty dark up there.
And hot. And then he said, "Don't make any sound." And he wouldn't let me move. And my wrists fell asleep because the handcuffs were too tight. And I couldn't keep my legs up, and I asked him if I could put my legs down. He said, "No," and then I started to. And he grabbed me. He grabbed my leg and said, "Stop moving, because if you make one sound, then I'm going to kill you right now." He said, "If I go, then you're going too."
Was he laying down next to you?
Well, there was a hole in the attic, a hole in the roof to get out, and I was like lying right there because he just threw me in there. And then he was sitting down like next to the hole like that, and I was like right there.
Okay, what do you remember happening after that?
Everyone kept, telling him to come out, and he was up there for about 45 minutes with me, and he wouldn't do anything. And then finally someone else got, like his aunt or his mom or something, got on the phone and told him to come out. They said, "Well, your sister's out here crying." And then he says, "I'm coming out."
Okay, did he have a towel up there in the attic with him?
But when, one of the cops gave it to me. He gave me a towel after.
So he told you that he was going out?
He didn't tell me. He just yelled that he was coming out.
Okay, he opened up the attic and went down. Did he say anything to you when he left?
Nothing. He just left me there. And then...
Did he cover the attic back up and put the board back on?
No. And then I untied my feet because I could, with my hands behind my back, they were right there and I just untied them. And then I turned over and I was looking down and I saw the door move. And then I said, "Is someone there?" And then someone came in the room and they put the gun up in the attic. And then I started yelling and I told them to get the gun away from me. And then one of the cops went in the attic and he gave me a towel and then he undid my handcuffs and gave me some clothes that were in the closet to put on and then they brought me down.